Hello friends, welcome to GT Science tutorial. In this video I'm going to explain about X-ray diffraction and Bragg's law. Bragg's law is very important because with the help of which we can study the internal structure of a crystal. So in this video we are going to see everything about these topics. So let's start. First of all, we need to understand about X-ray diffraction. In 1912, a scientist named Max van Leeuw found out that X-rays could be diffracted by crystals. X-rays have very high penetrating power, but still they could not penetrate the crystal. Let's understand that conceived by the figure. Max van Leeuw took copper sulfate crystal. He took copper sulfate crystal and he used X-ray to strike that. Okay, he used X-ray beams to strike that. Now what actually happened? Those X-rays got diffracted. He obtained those X-rays getting diffracted. Their direction completely changed. Okay, their direction completely changed. He thought that, first of all, earlier he had thought that the X-rays would easily penetrate through the crystal, but no, he found out that the crystal actually diffracted the X-rays, and he found that by using a photosensitive plate. He found out that X-rays could be diffracted by the crystal. Now he concluded that by seeing the diffraction pattern. We call that fringes, okay, diffraction fringe or pattern. You can see the figure over here. He got a diffraction pattern like this. He got certain bright fringe, he got certain dark fringe. Those fringe are also called spot, okay. You can see there is a big spot, big bright spot, right? Now we get those things by the combination of X-rays. Now let's use the concept of interference. What does constructive interference is? Constructive means making, right? Making interference. Making means if two light rays meet at a point, then obviously bright light occurs, but sometimes even dark spot gets created by the combination of two lights. Okay, you can see this is the light wave, or this is any wave. Wave travel in this manner. Now this is called crest, this is called trough, right? This is called trough, and the distance between these two points is actually wavelength, right? And here this height is called the amplitude. Now let us consider two light wave like this. Now you can see the wavelength of the amplitude of that light wave is also a crest, trough, and if the wavelength is also lambda, that means if everything about those two light waves or those two waves are same, and if they meet in phase means with proper orientation. Crest meeting crest, trough meeting trough, crest trough, okay, that is called proper orientation. If they meet like that, then it forms constructive interference. Okay, constructive interference, that is bright light is obtained, and it is obtained when waves are in phase. Okay, waves are in phase, then we get bright light. That bright light shows that two X-ray waves are meeting with completely phase. Okay, they are in phase. Now other type, that is the dark spot, is because of destructive interference. That is because of destructive interference. Now destructive means, suppose let me erase this part, okay, we have the same wave, but in this case In this case, they are in opposite orientation. That is, the crest meets the trough. Okay, that is opposite orientation. That is completely out of phase. Now, in this case, if two light waves or if any two waves meet, in this case, they form dark spot. Okay, that dark spot shows that two X-rays meeting there are completely out of phase. So this forms dark light, dark spot, okay, dark spot, and in this case waves are in out of phase. Waves are in out of phase. Okay, so this is what he found. This was a very big discovery, and this led the Braggs to find out a rule or a formula. Okay, they gave a formula that is named after their name, that is Bragg, and that formula is used to study the internal structure of a crystal. That is so important formula. Now, what actually happens in Bragg's law? Let's see that. W.L. Bragg and his father W.H. Bragg used X-rays to study the internal structure of a crystal. Now, the reason is, why did they use X-ray? Because X-rays have very high penetrating power? No, that was not the reason. The reason they chose X-ray for the study of internal structure of crystal was the wavelength of X-ray and the interplanar spacing of the crystals are of comparable length. Interplanar spacing means a crystal has a lot of planes like this. Okay, crystals have a lot of planes like this. Now we just need to measure the length, okay, and the wavelength of X-rays were of comparable length. Wavelength means this much of distance. Okay, this is the wavelength, that is denoted by lambda, and this is the interplanar spacing, DHKL. HKL means Miller indices. I have already made about Weiss indices in Miller indices. You can go and watch that video. You'll find the link in the description below. Okay, don't forget to check that. So DHKL means interplanar spacing between the two planes. Now, this is the reason why they chose X-ray for the study, because DHKL, that is the interplanar spacing, is of comparable length of lambda. Their length was almost same. Okay, almost same. That is the reason why they chose X-ray. Okay, now what did they actually say? We know that X-rays are diffracted from crystals, right? We know that X-rays are diffracted from crystals, but according to crystal, Listen to me carefully, okay? Suppose we are crystals now. X-ray is coming in this direction and it is going in this direction. Then, if I am the crystal, then I am reflecting the X-rays. Are you getting me? I am reflecting the X-rays, right? So, he chose that as a crystal consists of number of planes. So, it is not actually diffraction, it is actually reflection. Okay, let me repeat that one more time. It is not actually diffraction, but it is a reflection of X-rays from the crystal's plane. That's what they considered, and by using that concept they gave the law. So let me write that thing. Okay, you all start to see. W.L. Bragg and W.H. Bragg considered that X-rays are reflected from the planes of a crystal. They are reflected from the planes of a crystal. So this was their consideration. Now, according to this consideration, they imagined a condition, they imagined a theory, and they gave the formula. Now let's see what that formula is. Okay, let me erase this part. I will make the figure over here, the figure that they actually made. What they actually said was, let us consider there were three layers of a crystal. Okay, these are the three planes, BB dash, CC dash and DD dash. Okay, BB dash, CC dash and DD dash. I'm just putting the point so that it will be easy to make. You all can do this as well. 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3. Okay, now make a line so that it touches this point and this point. Make a line that touches both the point like this. Okay, similarly make another line that touches these two points. Now make another line that is parallel to this line but it ends over here. Okay, this is parallel line to this one and another line parallel to this ray. Now this is our figure. Now what they actually considered this distance to be DHKL. Okay, this distance to be DHKL and the light rays, sorry, the x-rays they considered was XYZ. Suppose they are XYZ and PQR. The x-rays are coming from this direction and they are striking the crystal. See, this x-ray struck the crystal plane and it got reflected along this direction. Similarly, another x-ray beam penetrated through one of the plane and struck the second plane and it got diffracted or reflected from that plane in the direction QR. Okay, now the angle of incidence, or we can say diffraction angle, is theta. These two will be theta. Okay, this is just like reflection. Okay, this is just like reflection, theta theta. Then these angles will also be theta because of corresponding angle nature, right? Now let's produce this line as well. This is 90 degree, this is also 90 degree. These are right angle triangle. Okay, these are the right angle triangle. Now this angle will be theta, this angle will also be theta. If you ask me how, then the sum of this angle and this angle will be 90 degree. Similarly, the sum of this angle and this angle also be 90 degree. So if we equate them, this angle will be cancelled out and finally we will get theta will be equal to theta. This angle will be equal to this angle. Okay, so this was the figure consideration made by them. This is M and N. Okay, figure reflection of x-rays from planes. Reflection of x-rays from planes. This is the figure. Now let me erase all this part so that we can do the derivation of it. I've already erased all the unnecessary part. Now let me write the description of this figure. Let BB dash, CC dash and DD dash are the planes. These are the planes of a crystal. Okay, DHKL is the what? Interplanar spacing, the distance between the two planes. Okay, DHKL represents that. XY and PQ are the incident x-rays. XY and PQ are the incident x-rays and YZ and QR are the reflected x-rays. Reflected x-rays, I have already told you that these are the reflected part. Okay, now forget about the diffraction, remember about the reflection. Here we are using the rule of reflection, that's why these are the reflected x-rays. Okay, theta is the angle of reflection. Reflection. This is also called Bragg's angle. Bragg's angle. See, everything about this theory is related to Bragg, right? This is also called Bragg's angle. Okay. Now, after this much, we gotta think about the path difference concept. Okay. Now, see, these two are parallel and equidistant. Okay. Parallel means equidistant, obviously. These two are parallel. Now, the distance between X and Y will be equal to distance between P and M only, right? This distance is equal. Similarly, on this side, the distance between YZ and NR are equal. Then, see the second X-ray, okay? That is PQ. It is actually moving extra distance. How much? MQ and QN. This is the extra path, right? As compared to the first X-ray wave, this is moving certain extra path. So this is the path difference, okay? Here, the second X-ray wave is moving extra path equal to how much? From here to here MQ and here to here QN. MQ plus QN. This is the extra path, right? That means this is the path difference between the two waves. Difference means subtraction. Just subtract the path moved by PQ and QR by QY and YZ. Then we will get MQ plus QN, right? Now here from trigonometric ratio, as you see, this is a right angle triangle, right? This YMQ is a right angle triangle. Then we can use trigonometry over here. Here this is 90 degrees, so its opposite side will be hypotenuse. This is theta, so its opposite side will be perpendicular, right? Now let's use the formula for sine theta to find the value of this MQ. Then what do we get? Sine theta is equal to P by H, perpendicular by hypotenuse, that is MQ by YQ. MQ by YQ. Now, we know that the value of YQ is how much? D. So, in place of this MQ, we need to write MQ, and in place of this YQ, we need to write D. Then, therefore, we will get MQ will be equal to cross multiplication D sine theta. D sine theta, and we know that this distance MQ and QN are same, then therefore QN will also be D sine theta. So this is also D sine theta. Now if we want to find the path difference, PD means path difference, okay, not potential difference, it is path difference in this case. Path difference is equal to MQ plus QN. And finally, we get d sine theta plus d sine theta. Now, how much will you get? Use algebraic rule. These are same thing. Then we will write 2d sine theta. If we add them, we will get 2d sine theta. So, this is the value for path difference between them. Now, let me erase the upper part so that we can proceed the derivation. We just found out the value of path difference, that is to be 2d sine theta. Now let's use the concept of optics, that is diffraction. Okay, we know that a bright light is observed when two light wave or two x-ray wave meet with phase, right? In that condition, okay, the mathematical condition for constructive interference, that is for bright fringe or bright spot, is, let me write that, The bright spot or light is formed. Bright spot or light is formed when the path difference, PD means path difference, is an integral multiple of lambda. Okay, when the path difference is an integral multiple of lambda. Integral multiple means multiply certain number with this lambda. If that condition satisfies, then we see a bright spot, that is the bright fringe, that is for constructive interference. For destructive interference, that is completely different, okay? Bragg's did not do that. So they gave the concept for constructive interference only. So what did they say? Path difference is equal to a integral multiple of lambda. Integral multiple, see, integer means numbers. So they considered n to be that number where n is equal to 1, 2, 3, dot, dot, dot. Okay. These represents the successive number of planes. N1 means first plane, N2 means second plane, N3 means third plane, and so on. Now, let's put the value of this PD, that was how much? 2D sin theta is equal to n lambda. So this is the formula that Bragg's gave. Okay, this equation is known as Bragg's equation. This equation is known as Bragg's equation. By using this equation, we can study the internal structure of a crystal. Now here, the components used are D. D means what? Interplanar spacing. Theta means what? Bragg's angle. And lambda means what? Wavelength. And n means integer multiples. So this is that equation. Now let's do a numerical problem by using Bragg's law, so that it will be very clear for us what is the use of Bragg's law. So let's see that. So let's see the numerical. The question is, what will be the wavelength of X-ray? That means we need to find the wavelength of the X-ray, which gives a diffraction angle 2 theta is equal to 16.8 degrees. So here the value of 2 theta is given, okay, twice the theta. From this we need to find the value of theta. For a crystal, if the interplanar distance in crystal is this much, that is interplanar distance is also given, and only second order reflection is observed. So this is the question. Now the solution of this question is, first of all, we need to write what is given. So here, what is given? 2 theta is given. 2 theta is equal to 16.8 degrees. So let's find the value of theta. We will get 16.8 divided by 2. Therefore, theta is equal to 8.4 degrees. So this is the value for theta. Similarly, what is given? Interplanar spacing is given. That is given to be 0.4 nanometer. Here it is given. And it is saying second order reflection. That means n is equal to 2. Okay, these are the given condition, and we need to calculate the value of wavelength. Now let's use Bragg's law using Bragg's law. We can write what is the formula for Bragg's law. Now try to remember, n lambda is equal to 2d sin theta. You need to remember the formula all the time, okay? Because this formula is easy, and if you don't remember the formula, it will be very difficult for you to do the numerical problem, to find different values. So you need to remember the exact formula. Now let's put the values. First of all, we need to find the value of lambda. So let's take n to other side. We get this form. Now let's put the values 2 into, in place of d, 0.4. into sine 8.4 degrees divided by n means 2. So this is how much we get. Now if we divide, we'll get 0.05188 nanometer. Okay, so this is the exact solution. Here we found out the value of lambda. Lambda means wavelength. Now, there are other numerical problems just like this. They are not different, okay? In certain question, you need to calculate the value for n. In other question, you need to find the value of theta. So, all the questions are almost similar. I hope you understood this numerical problem and you understood everything in this video. If you like the video, please share this video as much as you can. And thank you for watching the video.